The client said that we need these walls in dark gray, but I don't know how to do it.
Revit sucks, isn't it? Maybe we don't know it well. Javad is here, and in this video, let's learn how to control the graphics and the things that we see in Revit, and it will help us to control our bigger projects much better and control what we see and how we can put them in sheet. The first tool and the first window that we want to learn is object style. The object style is project based. When you change something in it, it will affect all of the project in all of the views. In object style, you can change the line and pattern of each category elements in the projection and the cut views. And also you can change the default material of each category too.
To access to object style window, you need to go to the manage tab, and in the settings panel, go to the object style. And for example, in here, find the category that you want. For example, I want to work with walls here. Let's search for walls. And in here, you have the line width for projection and cut. And also you have the line color, line pattern and material. And also you have these options for the annotations too, and for the analytical and also imported object. For example, for imported budget, you can change the layer color of AutoCAD. That's a bonus tip in here. And let's go back to the model object and let's find the walls in here and let's change the cut line width. But before that, let's turn off the thin line and see the line width in here. Again, go to the object style, and in here let's find the wall and let's bring it down from 3 to maybe 1 and let's see the result. And as I said, the object style works with all of the views and it's not specific to just one view. Or for example, let's go to 3D and let me turn on the section box. It's turned on but it is hidden. Let me bring it back. Let's select it and let's unhide it and let's see our section box in here. But I want to change the color of my section box. To do that, you need to go to the object style again, and in the annotation object, let's search for section box in this part, section box, and let's change it to red and let's bring the line thickness to something like 3. And for the line pattern, let's put it on center, click on OK, and now you have a new section box type.
After we've learned object style, it's time to learn about the visibility graphic or VG. In VG, when you change something, it is view based and you're only changing the view that you are in, or we can say active view. In visibility graphic, you can change the line pattern and some of the other graphical settings on each category. And also you can hide and unhide them very easily, but you need to know in visibility graphic, you can change the default material for element, and it is only available in object style.
Sometimes you want to change some specific part of your categories and we don't have them in object style, or you want to have them in just one view. That's the way that we work with visibility graphic. To access visibility graphic, you have two ways: to go to the view tab and click on visibility graphic, or you can press VG on your keyboard and you can access to this window that we have in here. The main usage of a visibility graphic for me is to hide some elements. For example, let's hide our walls. Let's find our walls and let's hide it. Just uncheck the visibility checkbox in here and let's click on OK and let's see the result. You can see we can't see any walls in this view. But when I go to the 3D, it is visible. So it's just a specific view option. Let's go to VG again and let's turn on the walls. And now let's check other options that we have. We have lines, lines, pattern, transparency, and lines and patterns. Also halftone and detail level. We have line pattern and transparency in projection or in uncut situations, and we have line and pattern in cut situations. For example, I want to make my walls dark gray in cut parts. For example, let's put the pattern, and let's assign a solid fill and a dark gray pattern to it, and click on OK and OK. You can see we have our walls in dark gray, and I don't want to see the hatch of my floors for this view, so press VG again. Let's go to the floors this time. In here, and because it's uncut and it's a projection part of our floor, let's go to the pattern, but in projection part, click on override, and in here, uncheck the visible option of your hatch, and then your hatch will be gone. Click on OK, and OK, and now we have our floors without any hatches. Or you can haft on your doors and windows. For example, let's go to the doors, and in here, let's haft on it. It will bring the, it will make it lighter, and it will be better to have our doors and windows lighter in some views. And let's go to the window again, and let's put it on halftone. Click on OK. Now you can see it is lighter right now. You can change the brightness of your halftone from the Manage tab, an additional setting. And in here, you have a setting in here. We have halftone or underlay, and you can make it lighter or darker. Click on make it lighter and click on OK. And now you can see they are much lighter here. You have other options for the annotation parts too, for example, for tags and all of those things. And also you have those options for your imported families or imported cats or imported other imported files in your Revit.
Before diving into hide and isolate options of Revit, you need to know that there are two different ways that you can hide and isolate your elements. We have permanent and temporary. In temporary, as the name describes, we temporarily hide our elements in Revit, but when we restart our Revit, the elements will be returned and we will see it. But in permanent part, when you restart your Revit, you can see them, and every time you want to unhide something, you need to do it manually.
To hide and isolate objects in Revit, you have some different way. For example, I want to hide this roof in here. Let's just select it, and then if you want to hide it temporarily, you can go down in here and click on this sunglass icon, and in here, let's put it on hide element. We have hide category or hide element. As the name describes, when you put it on hide category, it will hide all of the roofs. But when you put it on hide element, it will hide that specific element. Let's hide elements. Let's click on hide element. And by this frame that you can see, blue frame in here, you can understand that we are in a temporary hide and isolate part. If you want to make it permanent, you can click on this option and you can put it on apply hide isolate to view, and it will make it permanent, and you need to bring it back manually. Let's reset it and bring everything back, and let's do a hide category 2. You can use HH for hide element 2, or let's select the sunglasses icon in here, and let's select the hide category, and you will see no roofs in here. Or you can hide the hide category your ceilings in this part, and you will hide all of those categories. Let's bring all of them back, and let's use isolate option. For example, I just want to see this roof and this window, or maybe this wall in my view to work much better with them. To do that, select them, and in here, click on isolate element. We have the same thing in isolate too. Isolate element and isolate category. I'm not going to mention both of them again. So let's click on isolate element, and now we have just two elements that we've selected, and now we can work with them very easily in our Revit view. Let's bring them back, and now let's hide some elements permanently. To do that, you need to select your element and right click, and in here you have hide in view, and you can hide by element and hide by category. When you hide it, you can't see any specific frame in here, but maybe you are questioning how we can bring it back. To bring the permanent hidden items back, you need to turn on the reveal hidden item option in here, and now you can see the hidden item is in here. Just select the hidden item you want to bring it back, and now you can right click and you have unhide element. You can do it by categories too, but my suggestion is to use as less as you can from this permanent hide element and use visibility graphic options, filters, and temporary hide option, because sometimes it is confusing. You can't understand which items are hidden.
To understand underlay better, for example, assume that you've created your walls in the level 1 to level 2. The cut plan in Revit is somewhere in here, but when you go to the level 2, you can see nothing, and it is hard to draw and model the second level walls at the top of these ones. So we have an underlay option. When we turn it on, you will see the walls from the bottom floors, and then you can create your walls at the top of them.
Let's say that I've drawn and I've modeled my first level walls in Revit, but when I go to the level 2 to create my second floor or first floor walls, I can't see anything. So in here you need to go to the properties palette, and in here we have an underlay option, and from here put the none or on the bottom level or the level that you want to see it in this level. For example, I want to see the level one elements in here, and then you can specify the top range of it too, and also you can specify that you want to look down or look up. And in here you have the underlay options. If you want to select your underlay elements, you need to activate it from in here. Now you can select your underlay elements too. But let's turn it off, and now you can click on wall and you can pick the lines of your first floor walls to create your second floor walls really easy. Let's have an example in here. And you can see this is much easier to create our walls. And also, this was a session from my Revit architecture, a free Revit architecture course, that you can see the playlist in here. Go and learn Revit.